everyone, welcome to Jamf Pro and TeamViewer, supporting users wherever they are. We wanted to host this session today as it is very relevant and timely. We're outside the four walls of our organizations. Users may be in the office at times, part-time, or staying fully remote. Some people might be traveling on grandma's Wi-Fi. No matter where they are, though, they may find they need support. And that's where they're going to be calling their friendly IT admin to help them. We wanted to highlight with you today not only Jamf Pro, but an amazing solution, TeamViewer, with our integration. How easy it is to support users as they are working remote and as things are very pivotal during this time. I'm Kat Garbus. I'm a business development executive here at Jamf supporting our enterprise markets. And with me today are my amazing colleagues, Sam and Larry. Sam and Larry, would you mind saying hi real quick to everybody?
Thanks, Kat. Hi, my name is Sam Weiss, and I manage the Solution Partner Program at Jamf.
And my name is Larry Stiegel, and I'm a field sales engineer in the education division here at Jamf.
Thank you. So a quick look at our agenda today. We're going to chat through the power of MDM, support scenarios, provide an overview of our TeamViewer integration, and Larry's going to walk you through a demo and setup. We want to not only tell you about it, but we want to really show you how easy it truly is to leverage this integration and make it so much easier for IT admins and end users to leverage this integration for seamless support experience. So when we think of the power of MDM, device management continues to grow, improve, and is highly capable. There is so much you can do with zero touch from deployment, even with maintenance via our policies. People can work from really anywhere and get new apps, security changes, updates, all over the air. So much so you can usually set it and forget it. However, as you all know, that's not always the case. And especially when it comes to providing support, there will be times where IT perhaps needs to drive the car. So some support scenarios, or what you might have heard, and that could be explaining where's the downloads folder, perhaps guide someone towards system preferences. So many Mac users are pro users in my experience. However, that doesn't mean they are IT. And that also doesn't mean that they perhaps may not be familiar with things, especially if there are profiles on there. They might have system preferences hidden for compliance reasons, or perhaps there's just things moved around that they may not exactly know where to find them if they're trying to be their own IT. But sometimes we also may find just things break, things happen, and that's where they're going to need your help. Another scenario that's come up relatively recently, especially with user-approved MDM, Apple has very strong privacy fields, and we want to make sure we are supporting that. So perhaps it's as simple as explaining a change or what they need. And at the end of the day, no matter what you might have heard, perhaps they just plainly need help. So when we're outside the four walls of our organization, desk-sized support is probably not happening right now, and there are many more users in need of perhaps screen sharing. We found that 68% of Jamf admins needed to remotely connect to end-user devices to see what exactly was going on. Perhaps the end-user didn't know what happened or couldn't explain what they were seeing. Sometimes we just need to take over and drive the car and help them get to really where they need to go. And this is where our TeamViewer integration really comes into play. And to help with that, I'd like to introduce Sam Weiss.
Thanks, Kat. And it's great to be talking to you all about this today. For all those support scenarios and use cases Kat mentioned, Jamf is really excited to support IT professionals with new ways to connect with end users. The TeamViewer integration has been something we've wanted to do for a while. This time of remote work and learning has obviously driven needs for these types of workflows. What's great about the TeamViewer integration is that it's based directly on feedback from our customers. Through user surveys about this topic, we discovered that a large percentage of Jamf organizations already had TeamViewer in place. We did this because we wanted to fill widely known gaps that Jamf Remote, frankly, was never intended to solve. The most glaring of which, for those of you that know, is the ability to access off-network users. And COVID has forced so many of us home that this was not a viable solution. There's also the fact that Jamf Remote only ran on macOS. We realized that not all IT departments have a Mac for every support agent, but they should. But that was creating a barrier to providing support for end users. And lastly, admins and end users at our customer organizations expressed a need for more notification and heads up, really a knock-knock before entering, before screen sharing was allowed to occur on their machine. So this vision of attended access aligns with our Jamf values and the way in which we hope tools like this would be used. We're very excited for you to try this integration, and it's very easy to use. It's built on a bring your own license model. So you can first go acquire a TeamViewer license from their website or your preferred reseller of choice. And in just a few moments, Larry will show you just how easy it is to set up. But what's also neat is if you're an organization that leverages sites, you have the flexibility in how you want to make this functionality available. Once it's all set up, it's smooth sailing, creating remote administration sessions directly from the Jamf device record. This integration leverages self-service and notifications on the Mac, which makes it incredibly accessible and supports users thinking about self-service as that go-to destination to fix their own problems. And also, everything about the usage of this integration is reportable on your own server. It's very easy to see who made a connection to which device and even for what reason, increasing that transparency and trust for users and within IT. We're thrilled to get our first screen sharing integration out to you all to use and support your users with. I want to give a big thank you to TeamViewer for working with us, our beta client sites for testing some fresh code, and the Jamf teams that spent so much time working on this. I personally rely on the great work of the Spider Pigs team and the overall infrastructure manager team, so thank you all so much. I'd also like to mention, as we said at launch, Jamf has built a framework for screen sharing integrations that we might want to plug additional vendors into next. We would love your feedback on how this process works today, and then what partners would be most valuable for us to add next. Your answers always help, are always helpful to prioritize where we put our efforts. And with that, I'd love to pass it to Larry to give you a demonstration of just how easy this integration is to set up and use every single day.
Thanks, Sam. More than anything else, TeamViewer integration, as Sam pointed out, is viewable on the device record as it is in this case. I've simply pulled up an individual record here, and I can initiate through a very simple component of just notifying the end user that we're ready to go. So what does this look like in real world production? On the left, we have the support individual, and then on the right, we're going to have the computer that's out in the field. This can be down the hall, could be at a location somewhere in the city, or even across on the other part of the world. The individual has contacted support and requested assistance. So here, the individual could have notified us, in this case, their machine name. We go to the management component, and we'll enter in a reason for the call. In this case, my technician has decided to enter in the ticket number for a support call. And now we can send the notification to the user. In a moment, it'll appear. We click on the link to go ahead and bring up the TeamViewer console. And now, as you'll notice on the right screen, notifications are there telling the user. The user can simply, if they wish, click on the notification, or they can launch self-service and go to the bookmarks section. They click open. No need to tell the user any special codes or anything like that. All that information will be pre-populated. The support technician is going to do a quick connection. So they tell the end user, go ahead and download Quick Support. The client mounts the DMG on their desktop, and they launch the application. Since the application's been downloaded, the end user has to approve it, and they now have to agree to the end user license agreement. The code's in already. And the user can allow the remote session to be connected. All the population of privacy fields are done. All the user has to do is allow screen recording. Now, the nice part about this demonstration is the user on the right is a standard user and not an administrator. All the configurations were delivered through Jamf Pro. But as Sam pointed out, TeamViewer is not just a macOS product, it's also a Windows product. So, what does the experience look like from a Windows administration? Again, our support technician is going to go ahead and enter in the ticket number. They can send the self-service notification, just like we did on the Mac, and then they'll launch TeamViewer on their PC. Now, as we know, sometimes we have end users get a little bit anxious. So the support technician could just simply tell the end user, go ahead and launch self-service. Go to your bookmarks and go ahead and open. Now their browser would open. They would download the quick support link. And then mount the DMG. The user would launch the application on their Mac. Again, notification it was downloaded from the internet. They'll accept the end user license agreement. Again, the code is populated. No need for user interaction. They would agree to the screen view, and then the user simply approves the ability for the remote session to view his or her screen. From an end user's perspective, they don't know whether the support individual is running a Windows client or a Mac client, and frankly, they don't care. So TeamViewer setup is very, very simple when working with Jamf Pro. First thing we'll need to do is we'll need to log in to our TeamViewer management console. And we're going to get something that's called a script token. Once you log in, to retrieve a script token, you're going to navigate to the Edit Profiles. Up in the upper right corner, Edit Profile. And then what we're going to do is we're going to look for Apps. And then we're going to create a new script token. Once that information gets populated, you'll give a name to this script token, and if necessary, a description from the session management pop-up. You're going to choose Create, Edit, View, All Sessions, and then you're going to save. Make sure that you note that script token information. It's a combination of letters and numbers. Then we're going to pop over into Jamf Pro. We're going to go to the Settings section, and we're going to go to Global Management. In Global Management, we're going to click on Remote Administration. And then we're going to go to a New. And basically, you're going to follow the on-screen directions. If your environment includes sites and you're logged in as a Jamf Pro site full administrator, you must select the site for your configuration and add multiple configurations. The maximum session time setting allows you to control the session duration. It defaults to about 15 minutes. Most users are going to find that adequate, with a minimum value of 1 minute and a maximum value of 1,440 minutes. It's recommended use the minimum value greater than 5 minutes. Meetings started during the session are not terminated when the session times out. And then click Complete. And you'll notice your TeamViewer is there. Again, you'll need to build configuration profiles based on which type of TeamViewer application or system you want to use. We do support TeamViewer Quick Support, TeamViewer full normal. You can even use TeamViewer started as a service, and if you wanted to run a TeamViewer host. All of this is fully documented within your Jamf Pro administration guide, including information on how to build your configuration profiles. Basically, from going from the management console to supporting an end user, I was able to accomplish this in under 5 minutes.
Thank you so much. Thanks for making that look so easy and easy to also understand. We're very excited and we hope you learned something new today. To recap, we covered the power of MDM, support scenarios, the value of our partnership with TeamViewer. Once again, TeamViewer, we really want to thank you for your partnership and in this integration and working with Jamf. And again, we showed you a demonstration and setup that was very, very easy. So thank you once again for joining us today.